Today, I will be traveling to the coldest and iciest planet that I can find. Every one like equals one very, very warm hot cookie that I can eat. And yeah, I kind of need that so I can live. In preparation for today's video, I wanted to eat an ice cube. So here we have it, ice cube.
Okay. Oh, that's really cold. Okay. I don't like being cold. This is not gonna be a fun video, guys.
Betsy, why are we doing this ice challenge? Please explain it to me, alright? I sat on the ice throne just like you wanted me to, right over there. It was super cold. I ate an ice cube. I didn't even know what the heck's happening. Maybe this book called Ice Planet Challenge will, it'll clear it up a little bit. I challenge you to travel to the coldest planet you can find. If you can survive one day on an ice planet, I will give you 20 million cookies. Make sure to bring a sweater. Love, icy cold Bessie. 20 million cookies is more cookies than I have probably eaten in my entire 20 years of being alive. So I think I kind of probably have to do this challenge. If you guys think I could do it, definitely leave a like. Okay, remember, one like equals one warm cookie that I'm allowed to eat. So if we can get like 5,000 likes, then in real life, I can eat like 5,000 cookies. That is, unless Rodney steals them or somebody else comes in, the fake Bessies, or if you, wait, no, you're not allowed to have my cookies either. All right, guys, let's get right into it. We have a tier 10 creative rocket. We have a some like rocket launch pads, and we have a volcano pickaxe, which will hopefully be able to break through ice just in case I need it. Oh yeah, dude, this thing is awesome. Look, oh gosh, okay, my game crashed. So the volcano pickaxe, even though it's gonna keep me warm, yeah, I'm not allowed to use it. Bessie swapped out with this fiery pickaxe. Okay, hopefully, yep, it doesn't set stuff on fire. I don't really know what it does, but it definitely looks cool, and I think it should get the job done. I'm not entirely sure what planet I want to go to, but I know that I have to go to outer space nonetheless. So, Rodney, please get the heck out of my way, bro. I gotta travel to outer space. If you get out of my way, I will give you 5 cookies out of my 20 million. I actually should probably be careful about promising Rodney cookies, because, yeah, he might steal my 20 million cookies. So I gotta be careful, but let's get into my giant space rocket ship, and let's head up into outer space. Now, I know there's a ton of cold planets. I know that Pluto's really cold. I think there's a couple moons that are really cold. I don't really know if anything else is cold, though. All I have to do is just survive one single night on the coldest planet possible. I don't even know if I have to, like, go near fire or something, or if it's, like, realistic, or if I can even survive one night. But let's see. I should be able to check out the temperatures of each different planet. So this one is 50 degrees Celsius. That's way too hot. 5 degrees Celsius. Nah, 0 degrees Celsius is like the baseline. That's what's sort of normal. Mars is -1. Okay, that's nothing. We have asteroids. This one's -1. 90. No, that's way too high. We have Saturn is 70. Uranus is -115 degrees Celsius. Well, I guess this is where I'm launching, ladies and gentlemen. This is the coldest planet I think that I could find. Actually, I didn't check out Pluto, but maybe I could save that for another video. Bessie just told me to survive on a super icy planet, and this is a -100 degrees Celsius, which I'm pretty sure is below freezing by a ton of... Okay. Yep, it's definitely made of ice. I'm not entirely sure. Whoa, I think I'm in liquid nitrogen. Okay, what the heck? Oh my gosh, am I freezing to death? There's, what the heck? I forgot pressure protection. What does that mean? I think I managed to find some space helmets and space chest plates and space stuff. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely set now. All right, guys, we're gonna head into game mode 0, and hopefully I can survive one singular night. Okay, the pressure's nothing crazy here. There's not a lot of radiation, so I think I'm good. I'm gonna have to say this is probably the coldest planet, because, yeah, this is all made of ice, dude. I'm kind of even scared to break it. I don't know if my pickaxe is gonna get wrecked, but this is the iciest planet ever. There's giant ice spikes. There's literally liquid nitrogen, which I think is, like, one of the coldest substances. It is so cold that it actually damages me. I'm gonna eat another ice cube just so I can really feel how cold it is. All right, here we go. Cool. So, we have a ton of ice everywhere. It looks like we have some snow. There's giant nitrogen oceans, and the sun is really tiny. Oh my gosh, dude, it is so cold. It's freezing my mouth. Okay, it's fine, it's okay. I have to start working on a house. I don't see any trees anywhere, but I know for a fact I am very, very cold. Maybe I can build a little tiny igloo house inside of one of these icicles.
Okay, I got through the ice cube, dude. That was the worst thing ever. I hate eating ice cubes.
I like hot chocolate a lot better, or like a nice warm chocolate chip cookie or something. Oh no, oh no, okay. I can't have that. Break into the outside world. Okay, let's just add some ice bricks. All right, we might as well make it symmetrical. All right, cool. This could be my base station for the night. I'm actually not sure how long a day lasts here. It looks like we have the sun, and we have, I guess that's a moon, and we have another moon. That is actually super cool. So I have to remember where this little igloo house is. Or, I mean, I guess I could just make another one. Maybe there's a village on here, because I know that the other planets I normally travel to at least have a couple villagers that, you know, maybe they'll have some food, because Bessie didn't give me any. I'm kind of curious, can I use a boat on the nitrogen? Oh, it just sinks. Okay, wait a sec. What if I get inside? Okay, no, no, it does not work. It doesn't work. I need to jetpack now. No, I'm gonna die. Dude, are you joking? I died from hypothermia.
Of course, I spawned back in the water.
Oh my gosh, dude, it's so hard to swim in this stuff. Okay, let's get back on the ice. I don't even know how I'm dying. I'm in a giant, awesome spacesuit. I thought this would be enough to keep me warm, but I guess not. There is a couple underground caverns. Oh my gosh, dude, okay, it just kind of keeps going on. I don't know, are we supposed to have caverns here? This is so weird, dude. I don't know if in real life we've ever been to Uranus or anything like it, but this is honestly amazing. It's so quiet. It is super beautiful, though. The only problem is that, you know, it's negative, like, 100 degrees. I'm not entirely sure why Bessie wants me to try and survive on here, dude. There's literally no point. Maybe she's trying to do some weird experiments on me where she wants to see the effects of it. But looks like we found another biome. This is, like, a snowy biome. I'm guessing the snow biome is a little bit warmer, if you even want to say that, dude, than the giant ice plains biomes. There's also just giant oceans of liquid nitrogen. I'm actually not even sure what that is, dude. It could be some very, very just strange substance that, it just literally freezes you as soon as you touch it. But I really need to find a village or else I'm gonna die. I'm running out of food. There is literally so much ice in every single flipping direction. There has to be some sort of life here, dude. There has to be some sort of like weird snow villagers or something. There's what the, okay, there's, is that an ice spike way up in the sky? I'm not entirely sure. Wait, hold us, oh, what, dude? Okay, these look like ice villages. The only problem is this is under water. I'm not entirely sure if I'm gonna be able to get to them. Are there any villagers down there? There's literally no way, dude. I'm guessing these are like ancient villages from, you know, when it was maybe warmer on this planet. I don't really know, but dude, these look so cool. I'm looking for any signs of life. Is there any villagers down there? There are houses, but yeah, there's no way I'm gonna be able to check that out. It's actually perfect timing too, because it's getting nighttime. What the? Wait, we actually have, yo, there's ice villagers. They don't even have fire. They're literally on, dude, look at, they're made of ice. I don't know how they're surviving. What the heck is going on with my textures? Okay, I look very weird, but still, dude. I don't know how they're surviving. This is insane. Half of their village is just buried under liquid nitrogen. They have trades and everything. Do you guys have any food that I could borrow? Okay, I don't have any trades. Could I give you some ice? Here you go, I'll give you that. I'll give you 5 Uranus stones. Super valuable, yeah, they're super rare. You could probably trade them on Earth for like $1,000,000. If I could maybe have some meat now or something to keep me warm, because I don't think I'm gonna survive on here much longer. Oh gosh, dude, it's nighttime. I'm actually like kind of close to morning, I think. What is that thing? What's that? I didn't look at it. It's an Enderman, dude. It is an ice evolved Enderman. Get away. Okay. All right. I have to take this thing out. Oh my gosh, dude. Okay. If I could just kill this thing, I'll be perfect. I won't have to worry about him. You do know it is like negative 100 degrees out here. You know this, right? He literally is white from being so cold. He's on ice. It just does not matter though. There's skeletons too. How is all this stuff surviving? I have to find a cave system or something. ASAP. There has to be a place to hide. I don't want to hide with the villagers. They seem super weird, and they're super cold, and they don't even care. It looks like under the village, okay, there's a, whoa, dude, ice caverns. I don't know. Okay, I have to figure out how to turn on night vision. I'm pretty sure the spacesuit has some. All right, let's turn them on. There we go. We have night vision, and oh, what is that? It's an ice creeper. No, okay, there's like 18 different directions to go in. Oh, let's try this way. Okay, there's liquid nitrogen. Dude, I do not know where the heck I'm going. It just kind of goes deeper and deeper. All right, I gotta bust my way through. Dude, there's literally no other direction to go. Please tell me I'm not trapped. Okay, maybe I can jump over it. There we go, and we can just keep going deeper. Maybe the deeper I go into the surface, it'll get warmer? Eh, whatever, dude. It's probably gonna become morning soon. Let's just head straight down and see what happens. Hopefully there's not, like, nitrogen pockets or, like, explosive ice anywhere. Okay, it definitely goes deeper. I don't want to look at anything. What the heck? There's frozen ores? Hold on, what kind of ore is this? We have crystals. Maybe if I take back some of these for Bessie, she'll give me even more cookies. Maybe that's why I'm here, actually, to discover ice, frozen, crystals. There is literally an entire system down here of stuff. Why is everything iced out? Okay, gotta head down. Just keep going down further. What the heck, dude? We made it to bedrock.
Yep. Stop, Mr. Enderman. Seriously, dude. Really? We're gonna fight down here on bedrock on an ice planet? This is how I'm gonna die. Not today. Not today, bro. All right, we have an ender pearl. I'm getting the heck out of here. I'm getting home, and I'm getting my 20 million cookies.
This is honestly amazing, okay? I may have to come back here. It's just so beautiful. There's like ice in every single direction that you look. The liquid nitrogen looks amazing, but the only problem is I think I might be trapped out here.
Well, the only way to get back to the surface is to just get wrecked. So, okay, yeah, just do your worst, bro. Seriously, you can't damage me. He hasn't done a single bit of damage to me. How about Mr. Creeper? How you doing, buddy? You wanna explode? You wanna, okay, dude, what is going on? Can nothing destroy me? Am I invincible now? Maybe the only way that I could die is by the Enderman or by the nitrogen. Let's go see. Is there any nitrogen around? Because I really don't want to be down here anymore. It was a lot of fun, but at the same time, dude, I'm getting frozen to death. Oh my gosh, dude. I literally had to dig my way out. But dude, yes, it's morning. We complete the challenge.
Well, it's time to get off this very, very cold and icy planet. I would like to say I had a lot of fun, but no. I do not like being cold, and this was the coldest I've ever been in my entire life.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I do hope you enjoyed today's video. I'm gonna head back home, claim my 20 million cookies, and I'll try and share some with you, all right? If you left a like on today's video, I'll tell Rodney to send you some awesome cookies. But ladies and gentlemen, I think that is going to wrap it up for today's video. If there is any other planets you want me to survive on, leave a like and comment them down below. But ladies and gentlemen, that's gonna be it. My name is Beck Bro Frozen, and I will see you guys all back in here tomorrow. Peace out, dudes.